It's the start of a new school day in the central west of New South Wales. But these First Nations boys aren't heading to just any ordinary school. 14-year-old Stephen didn't like going to school until he secured a place in the Ngurang-gu Yalbilinya program, Wiradjuri, for place of learning.
I was getting in a lot of fights and sometimes I'd get a suspension warning or two. I'd be wagging classes and everything. The teachers here really helped me. It has helped me a lot through the tough times.
They do things differently here. Teacher Tim Bennett says the program works hard with the local community to engage the kids and ensure families receive all the support they need. The kids are picked up and dropped off, fed at school, and taken to health and other appointments as they need.
It's not just an academic need, it's also a trauma. If the child suffered trauma or the family suffered trauma, that could also affect the student engaging in mainstream classes. So we have to address that as well.
The program led by the local Aboriginal community has had some incredible success. Over the past 2 years, 33 students have participated, with school attendance more than doubling from 44% to 94%.
That's the biggest plus for me, is they're just attending school. The second thing for us as a team here is the improvement in their literacy and numeracy. We work on that to lift that so they can actually engage in mainstream classes.
June's grandson was one of the first students in the program and says it's been life-changing.
He did part of year 9 and 10 and he said he would have been probably in jail by now if he hadn't have got into this course. Yes, he was getting himself into trouble and, you know, it just to get into this program was the best thing for him.
As well as the usual school subjects, culture is a central part of the curriculum.
Can we all say Wurundjeri?
From learning Wurundjeri language to practising the craft of traditional wood carving. Cultural lessons are taught by local elders, giving the kids a chance to connect with their identity.
I think most of them don't know much about their background, their cultural background. And once you teach them, it sort of gives them a sense of identity in themselves, yeah. So, yeah, I think you don't know your past, you don't know your future, yeah.
The students also feel the benefits.
I've been connecting way more at home. I've showed my mum and dad my didgeridoo and played it in front of them too. My mum thought it was very good.
Danielle is a single mum of four boys. Her son Logan joined the program a year ago. She says the program has changed her life.
It's allowed me to go back to work. With constantly being at the school and constantly having Logan home suspended or in trouble, I couldn't be at work. I had to be at home. There was no other option. It's just made a huge difference.
The program was revived with the help of the local Orange Aboriginal Land Council 2 years ago, after it was abandoned by one of the local high schools.
And we had students and parents coming to us, and we had children in tears, we had ex-students coming saying how great the program was. So we fought back and worked with the department to get the program off-site.
The population of Orange is younger than most in New South Wales, and it's growing. Of the around 50,000 people that live here, almost 8% are Aboriginal. Community leaders here believe a key to the success of the town and the education program is having wraparound services that support the whole family.
33 students are on the waiting list to get into the program, and many other communities want help.
You know, some communities are crying out for programs to actually keep those kids in school. The success of the program in Orange shows us that, you know, Aboriginal people have always had the answers.
Discussions are underway with the Department of Education over a possible expansion, but teacher shortages and a lack of funding have hampered the efforts to replicate it in other regional towns.
What we're going to the department with is if this can achieve an outcome for these kids to re-engage in school, you know, it shows that education is the foundation of everything. And with your support, you know, they're getting what they need as far as data, but the kids get what they need as far as education.
There's real opportunity to build the capacity within community. Let's do what we've actually signed up to do.
Anne Denner's played a key part in getting the program up and running, but she's seen programs like this come and go. She believes a voice to Parliament could be the link needed to secure its future.
The government needs some direction from all of Australia to say enough is enough, this needs to happen.
So a voice is good as long as they hear. They don't just sit there and listen. They actually hear what communities need and want.